The Volkswagen new Beetle has to be the fun car of this decade. No other machine that we've encountered recently has the new Beetle's ability to just make people smile. But life isn't all fun and games, and Volkswagen wants the new Beetle to appeal to the public's practical side as well. So there's also a new bug fitted with a high-mileage direct-injection turbo-diesel engine. Do playful and pragmatic finally go together? They do now, and no one is better qualified to oversee the mix than the people at Volkswagen, seeing as how they've had over 30 years of experience doing the same thing with the original Beetle. Albeit from a technical standpoint, not nearly as successfully as they have with the new Beetle TDI. As the saying goes, we've come a long way, baby. And where we're at today is a Volkswagen Beetle with a water-cooled engine in the front, which for Beetle buffs is in and of itself a novel concept. Now add the fact that this engine is a diesel capable of delivering nearly 50 miles per gallon, and the people's car looks better than ever. This advanced power plant is a 1.9-liter four-cylinder turbocharged direct injection diesel engine that takes advantage of high-tech diesel engineering to inject and ignite fuel directly into each combustion chamber. While the 90 horsepower result is modest, the TDI cranks out a bonanza of low-end torque. 155 pound-feet at only 1,900 RPM. That's 27% more than the 2-liter gas engine, but with 20% less of the greenhouse gas carbon dioxide. You also get something else with the TDI, just enough diesel clatter to remind you of the distinctive exhaust burp of the original Beetles. This midget torque monster propelled us from 0 to 60 in 10.9 seconds, just 2/10 of a second slower than the 2-liter gas model we tested earlier this year. Our new Beetle came with a 5-speed manual transmission, but an adaptive 4-speed automatic is also available. Even in its second year, we're still crazy for the new Beetles carved from a solid rainbow styling, and smile at those tall 16-inch alloy wheels. And from all the high signs we've been getting out on the road, we're hardly alone. We also like the hatchback's practical 12 cubic feet of available cargo space, made even larger when the rear seats are folded flat. The new Beetle's substantial character is not superficial, however. Our handling test confirmed that. Drivers love the near-neutral characteristics offered up by the nicely weighted power-assisted rack and pinion steering. Turn ends are crisp, and side-to-side transitions are handled with a minimal amount of body roll. Our crew finds the new Beetle's adhesion to pavement confidence-inspiring. But it's a different story with the brakes. Our late 98 TDI didn't have anti-lock, and the front disc and rear drums consistently locked at both ends. Stops were longish at 130 feet from 60. VW must agree with us, since 99 new Beetles get ABS standard, a good move. That's one less thing to worry about on all those long drives in the country the new Beetle is so well suited for. The fourth generation Golf-derived chassis with struts up front and torsion beam axle behind delivers a surprisingly compliant and congenial ride. Congenial also describes the new Beetle's interior as well. Trim choices are cloth, vinyl, and leather. We love having seat-mounted side impact airbag standard. We're told 99 bugs get revised headrest and, thankfully, bigger cup holders. Ambiance is provided by an original-style gauge cluster, but with ultra-modern blue backlighting. And an AM-FM cassette stereo pre-wired for an optional 6-disc CD changer. Plenty of available hot and cold air, and, of course, the Bud Bar. We won't recommend long drives in the tiny rear seat, but sturdy grab handles are there when it comes time to pull yourself out. As for how much money you'll have to pull out, new Beetle prices remain affordable despite unbelievable popularity. $1,999 prices for the base car, now known as the GL, are up $700 to $16,425, but that does include anti-lock brakes. A new GLS model adds power windows, cruise control, and fog lamps for $17,375. Our new Beetle GLS TDI adds $1,050 more for $18,450. A premium you'll recoup quickest if you plan to rack up a lot of new Beetle highway miles. And with the Volkswagen new Beetle TDI, that's encouraged. Pragmatic and playful? No question. And there's probably no other car on the planet that makes you want to belt out a chorus or two of Good Day Sunshine as you pull away from the pump.
I hope you'll join us next week for more Motorweek.
We'll test the V8-powered Mercedes-Benz ML430 Sport Ute and the new four-door Nissan Quest minivan. I'm John Davis. We'll see you then.
To learn more about Motorweek, television's original automotive magazine, visit us at PBS Online at the internet address on your screen. Motorweek has been brought to you by Castrol Super Clean All-Wheel Cleaner, the cleaner that releases brake dust and road grime from all types of wheels on contact, no matter what age your car. Castrol Super Clean All-Wheel Cleaner. And by Michelin, makers of the Zero Pressure Michelin, designed to let you drive up to 50 miles at 55 miles per hour without air pressure. Just what you expect from Michelin. To order a video cassette of this program, call 1-800-422-0064.